Okay, can you guess what is this lesion? Can you guess the lesion? If you don't know, say no, it's okay. It's okay if you don't know.
No.
Say no if you don't know. Okay, this one?
Erythrasma.
Exactly, very good, erythrasma. This one?
Vitiligo.
Very good, vitiligo. This one?
No, no.
This one? Any idea? If you don't know, say a no, it's okay.
Papules.
Sorry?
Papule.
I'm not able to hear you clearly.
No,
Anyway,
ma'am.
This one? It's okay. This one? This all you should do. So the so-called blackheads, right? What do you call blackheads in the medical terms? Okay, this one? This one? Any idea?
Bullous.
This one?
So yes, yes.
Sorry? No, no, not psoriasis. Psoriasis will be
in
complete sclerosis. No. This one? What's this one? This one? Any idea?
Yeah.
Okay, it's okay. Even if you don't know, it's not a problem. We will learn it as it goes. Okay, first we'll do the theory part and then I will come back to the same pictures and then we'll discuss what are the pictures. Theory part in skin. What are the layers of epidermis? Stratum corneum. Stratum lucidum. Stratum granulosum, stratum spinosum, and then the stratum basale or the germinatum. The corneum will have squamous mucinous cells, and the lucidum, it will be seen only in the palms and the soles. Granulosum is with granular cells, and you see odd-gland bodies in the granulosum layer. Spinosum has the synthesis of keratin. And the Langerhans cells. What are Langerhans cells? These are the what types of cells? Come on, these are the macrophages of the skin, right? Macrophages of the skin. Okay. Stratum basale is the deepest layer and it is the layer where you have the proliferation of keratocytes. Right? This is what is regarding the epidermis. Then coming to sweat glands. You have eccrine sweat glands and apocrine sweat glands. What is the disease of the eccrine sweat glands? It is the milia rubra. Right? Apocrine sweat glands, you call it as apocrine milia, or if you call it as the fox for day spots. Fox for day spots is the one you call it as the disease of the apocrine gland. How about the nail growth? Fingernails grow at the what mm per day? It will be 0.1 mm per day. As toenail, it will grow 0.03 mm per day. Right, this is what is regarding the growth of the nails. Next, coming to the UV rays, which is used in the treatment of this any skin lesion, you use UV rays, right? UV rays with a wavelength of 320 to 400 nanometer is used for the pupa therapy. The UV rays with 280 to 320 nanometer is very essential for us. It comes from the sunlight for us. It helps in the synthesis of vitamin D. Okay. A UV light, which is in the wavelength of 250 to 280 nanometer, is very harmful to the body. It is very dangerous to the lymphocytes. It is very dangerous to the lymphocytes, right? The UV rays are also used in the diagnosis of skin diseases, right? In the diagnosis of skin disease, you can diagnose it with either a dioscopy or with a wood lamp. Usually in a dioscopy, the lesions are pressed with a glass light. If the lesions are pressed with a glass light, if it blanches with pressure, it is a hemangioma. If that lesion gives an apple jelly appearance in the microscope, if that glass light gives an apple jelly appearance, it is lupus vulgaris. Right? These are the ways of diagnosing the skin diseases. Wood lamps, what is a wood lamp? It is basically a mercury vapor UV lamp. It emits UV light in the 360 nanometer wavelength. And it uses a wood's filter, which is made up of barium silicate with the nickel oxide. This helps in emitting the UV rays in the wavelength between 320 to 400, ideally 360. Right? In this wood lamp, how do you diagnose it? Whenever the particular lesion is exposed to a wood lamp, if it gives a golden yellow color, what is the lesion? If it gives a golden yellow color, the lesion would be tinea versicolor. Okay, these are important things that you have to know. Golden yellow wood lamp color will be tinea versicolor. If it is pinkish red, it will be porphyria cutanea tarda. Porphyria cutanea tarda. If it's a coral red appearance, it will be erythrasma. If it's an yellow green appearance, it would be tinea capitis. If it's pale blue, it could be either psoriasis or it could be a pseudomonas. Right? If it is blue white, then it is tuberous sclerosis. If it's a chalky white, it will be vitiligo. Right? If it's also coral red, the another differentiation of coral red would be, another differential diagnosis of coral red would be a Cornibacterium minutissimum infection. Cornibacterium minutissimum infection. This will cause the this will also cause a coral red appearance in case of in a wood lamp, right? Then Coming to few terminologies in dermatology, like xerosis, where you see xerosis? Xerosis is basically dryness of skin, right? That is seen in vitamin A deficiency. Then purpura. Purpura is an extravasation of blood inside the dermis that results in either a petechiae, small, tiny, pinpoint lesions, purpura. Pinpoint purpura is nothing but a petechiae. What is an ecchymosis? Ecchymosis is a large plant purpura. Right? Then acral lesions. These are the lesions which are present in the hand and the foot. The end of the body is hand, foot, mouth disease. You have this acral lesions in the hand, the mouth, and the toe fingers. Then annular lesions will be round lesions. So vegetation will be seen in granuloma, annularis, annulare. Granuloma, annulare. Then gutted lesions. Gutted lesions are usually drop-like lesions, right? Example, it is seen in gutted psoriasis. Then, morbilliform lesions. Morbilliform lesions, these are usually macules and papules. They are seen in lesions. Then, reticular lesions. These are lesions which have a net-like pattern. It is seen in example, lipido reticularis. Then satellite lesions. These are scattered outside of the primary lesions. Example, candida dermatitis. Right, then serpiginous lesions, where will you see example? Serpiginous lesions travels like this inside the body. Just like a snake. What is it? Example? Very easy, cutaneous larva migrates. Cutaneous larva migrates. Then target lesions. Like how you have a dartboard, there will be multiple levels in the dartboard, right? Those are the target-like lesions that will be seen in erythema multiformis. Erythema multiformis, right? This is what is regarding the few terminologies. Then coming to few named lesions like milia, we already discussed milia as the white papule with keratin. It is mainly because of the sweat gland inflammation, sweat gland problems. It will be like this. What is telangiectasia? Telangiectasia is a condition where you have small superficial dilated vessels. The vessels will be all dilated at the surrounding area. It can happen in many areas like scleroderma, long-term topical steroids, hereditary hemorrhagic telangiectasia, basal cell carcinoma. It can happen in anywhere. Then spider angioma, just like a spider web, from the center, the blood vessels will get dilated like this. It will be like a spider web. Red central punctate arteriole with the telangiectatic network of dilated capillaries radiating from the center. The typical lesion is on pressure, they will disappear. When you release the pressure, it will reappear. That is a typical of spider angiomas. Then burrows. Burrows, it's just a tunnel inside the epidermis. If it's small, short burrows, these are because of the scabies. if it is a long tortuous burrows, it is because of the hookworm infestation. Right? Then the blackheads, what do you call it, blackheads? The blackhead is because of the blocking of the sebaceous follicles, right? That is nothing but the acne. What do you call it as? It is called as the comedon. Right? It is called as the comedon. This is what is regarding the few important lesions. Then coming to the differential diagnosis will be like too many things. It will be very difficult for you to learn that. So I will skip that part. Say red papule means what could be the possibility. Brown papule means what could be the possibility. That is too vast and it is not possible to remember everything. Regarding the scales, few disease will have scaly appearance, right? If it's a gray scale, what could be the possibility disease? It is a eczema. It's a silvery scale. This psoriasis. If it is a greasy yellow scale, this seborrheic dermatitis. It is seborrheic dermatitis. If it is a sandpaper-like scale, it is solar keratosis. If it is a yellow brown scale, if it's an yellow brown scale, it is various disease. Then, fine cigarette paper like scale, it is seen in vitreous rosea. Then, perspicacious scales. These are seen in the vitreous versicula. These are seen in the vitreous versicula. What is regarding the scales? Then coming to the pigmentations and their differential diagnosis. Hypopigmentation, hyperpigmentation. It's hypopigmentation. Of course, one possible thing is albinism, where you have a reduced or a no melanin production. Could be hyperbalism, where you have a disorder of melanocyte development. Then vitiligo. It is a melanocyte development disorder. Then nevus. It is an epidermis hematoma. It is an epidermis hematoma. Then hyperpigmentation could be a freckles where you have an increased activity of the melanocyte. Melasma, where you have a brown macular pigmentation. Then lentigens. Lentigens is a condition where the increased melanocyte number, okay, number of melanocytes will be increased. This is what is regarding the differential diagnosis of hypo and hyperpigmented disorders. Then coming to few named disorders that you have to know of. Dermatitis carpeticollis, it is basically a papillary tip abscess and it is associated with lupin sensitive enteropathy. There's an IGA deposition at the against IGA deposition against the epidermal basement membrane. Treatment of choice, it could be that it's Dapsone. Dapsone is the treatment of choice. Whereas prevention is by avoiding gluten-rich foods. Avoid gluten-rich food. Right? This is what is called as the dermatitis herpeticosis. Then there are conditions which is called as alopecia areata, where the problem in this condition, areata, right? So, anagen phase of the hair development is prematurely arrested. The anagen phase is prematurely arrested. Usually, they have this exclamation mark hairs. The hands will look like an exclamation mark in the microscopic examination. That will be a typical feature of this alopecia areata. Then you have to know the diseases which cause scarring alopecia and non-scarring alopecia. Scarring alopecia, examples, lichen planus, leprosy, lupus vulgaris, linear, scleroderma, lupus, erythematosus. Right, these are examples of scarring alopecia. Non-scarring alopecia, you have the androgenic process. Then thyroid disorders. Ectodermal dysplasia. Then mineral deficiencies. And drugs. Few drugs can also cause this non-scarring alopecia. So, this can be a hint in the diagnosis. Mainly, apart from non-scarring, the scar, then alopecia is the one which can be asked in the examination. By giving the clinical history, they can give a history of scarring alopecia. It helps you to come to the conclusion of all this DL. Okay? Then, coming to warts and their positive things, positive conditions, warts. Massive wart is caused by venereal warts. You know the answer to venereal wart. And filiform wart. Basically, what is a wart? It is a hypertrophy of that particular lesion in an ugly manner. Plain wart and plantar wart. Yes, tell me, at least tell me venereal wart alone. That is a very important question which you cannot forget. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me. Venereal warts, where do you see? Think and tell me. The lesion in the penis. Venereal warts, you've seen condyloma acuminata. Okay, venereal warts you see in condyloma acuminata. then massive, what you see it in the DL tumor, Paschke Lowenstein's tumor. Filiform what you see in verruca filiform. Filiformis. Plain plot in verruca plana. Whereas plantar what you see in verruca plantaris. Right? These are very important MCQ points that you have to know of. Then you have to know about the dermatological disorder that is associated with nail change. Whenever there is a pits in the nail, it could be either psoriasis or it could be alopecia areata. Whenever it is pterygium. What is pterygium? The nail is there means it growth like this. This is the pterygium. Whenever it's a pterygium, it could be either lichen planus or it could be a scleroderma. Okay, whenever you have a hyperkeratosis, which is wedge shaped. Is Darius disease. Whenever it is a hyperkeratosis, yellow brown color, it is pityriasis rubra pilaris. These are the dermatological conditions that is associated with the nail change. Then coming to few other nail changes and their diseases. These line where you see these line will be seen with poisoning. What poisoning? Arsenic poisoning. Knees line with arsenic poisoning, onycholysis. It is seen in sometimes in trauma or in use of tetracyclines, psoriasis, hyperthyroid. Fungal nail infections. Then pterygium we already discussed. Then pits also we already discussed. Then coming to few important dermatological disorders of importance in the exam, lichen planus. Whenever you think of lichen planus, you have to remember 6 P's. Papule, plain topped, polygonal purpura, pruritus will be there, along with the pterygium of the nail. And on microscopy, they will have the cigarette bodies along with the Witham striae. Witham is in a white color striae. Witham striae. Right, this is what is regarding lichen planus that is important. Then, psoriasis. Psoriasis is an increased turnover of the skin leading to the thinning of the suprapapillary epidermis. Right? They will have silvery scales. The important sign is the auspice sign and Munro microabsis. Munro microabsis will be seen. And of course, they also present with onychorexis or onycholexia, onycholysis, that is the skin nail lysis. It is the HLA CW6 associated. Right, it is HLA CW6 associated. These are the points of psoriasis that you have to know of. Then atopic dermatitis. Usually they will have the white dermatographism. They will have this white color dermatographism, that is white color patches on the skin, and they would be lichenification will be present. They present with a perioral pallor and Denny Morgan fold. Right, these are the points that you have to know in atopic dermatitis. Dermatomyositis, you know, it is an autoimmune condition. Points to remember is poikiloderma. The lesions will be of different size. It will not be same size and shape. It will be different size. And paleotropic rashes will be present. And the papules that are seen are typically called as the Gautron's papule. The papules will be typically called as the Gautron's papule. This is what is regarding the dermatomyositis. Then seborrheic dermatitis. Is basically the you have it in either in the babies or in AIDS patients. These patients will have a cradle cap appearance. And it will be like a stuck on appearance that you are not able to clean that dermatitis off. And they also present with the Munro's microabsis of the skin. So that is seborrheic dermatitis. Then coming to pityriasis. Pityriasis rubra and pityriasis rosea you have to know. Pityriasis rubra, here it will be on keratin scales will be present on the lesion, along with an erythroderma, redness of the skin will be there. And these patients also present with an yellow brown nail. Right? Pityriasis rosae, here there will be a cigar paper like appearance. And they have this herald mother patch. One patch will be very big, that is a herald mother patch, and the remaining will be tiny ones. And they have this Christmas tree pattern of distribution. Center, it will be more, as opposed to the side, it will be less. That is the Christmas tree pattern of distribution. Right? And then in pemphigus, you have to Then we have to know about the pemphigus. That is the pemphigus vulgaris. And the bullous pemphigoid. Both are autoimmune diseases that will present like in bullous pemphigoid, it will be a tense bulla, which is subepidermal location, that is a subepidermal bulla present, and is basically an autoimmune where the immunoglobulin G will be against the epidermal basement membrane. And you treat them basically with the steroids. Right? Then pemphigus vulgaris, you have a flaccid bulla, which will appear like a fishnet pattern. And it will be an intra-epidermal bulla. Acantholysis will be present in the histological feature, and Nikolsky's sign will also be present. These are the points of pemphigus vulgaris and bullous pemphigoid that you have to really know. Then there is one lesion that is tuberous sclerosis. As soon as you remember the name tuberous sclerosis, you have to remember two things. One is the ash leaf spot and the shagreen patches. And of course, we already know that the tuberous sclerosis is associated with the infantile spasm. Right? This is what is regarding the important skin diseases that is of concern for us. If you ask me about few dermatological signs that are significant in diagnosing the particular disease, if it's a bulla means, bulla spread means, definitely it will be some sort of pemphigus. If it is a carpet tract sign, it will be a diffuse lupus erythematosus. Then cribriform tongue sign. Cribriform tongue sign, you see it in pemphigus vulgaris. Hook down sign. You see it in genio versicular. Dubious sign. You see it with the congenital syphilis. Right? Then the HOV sign. You see it with atopic dermatitis. Ollendorff sign. You see it in secondary syphilis. The shawl sign or the curtain sign we see in dermatomyositis. Shawl sign means like that in that area, it will be like this. Like a curtain falling. In the curtain, like a curtain falling. That will be seen in dermatomyositis. So these are the important key points that they can ask you in an MCQ to come up with that, to come up with a diagnosis. Similarly, you have many dermatological key points that helps us in diagnosis. Say, complex spots, where will you see? Complex spots, where will you see? Complex spots.
measles.
Where is he?
Measles.
Seen in measles. Right? Rose spot. Rose spot is seen in the typhoid. Acrodermatitis myopathica. Acrodermatitis enteropathica. Where do you see?
Zinc deficiency.
Zinc deficiency. Then where do you see this crocodile skin? Crocodile skin or the soroderma? Where do you see this? You see this in ichthyosis vulgaris. Right? Then where do you see oral hairy mucoplasia? Oral hairy lipoplasia, you see it in the face. Then, where do you see the barrier sign? You see it in Urticaria pigmentosa. Where do you see pseudo barrier sign? Pseudodiarrhea sign will be seen in mastocytosis. Right? Then raindrop pigmentation. It will be seen in chronic arsenic poisoning. Denny Morgan's fold, where do you see? We already discussed. Denny Morgan fold, you see an atopic dermatitis, right? Acinetic petioles. Acinetic petioles along with the leaf nodule on the iris, where do you see? You see it in neurofibromatosis. You see it in neurofibromatosis. Where do you see slap cheek appearance?
ROS.
Slap cheek appearance is seen in erythema infectiosum. Slap cheek appearance is seen in erythema infectiosum. Then spongiosis will be seen in eczema. Then where do you see rhinopyoma? Rhinopyoma. You see it in acne rosacea. Right? These are the important things that you have to know. Then coming to few diseases and the test by which it can be diagnosed. How do you diagnose atopic dermatitis? I told you earlier it is diagnosed by clinical examination. Chancroid is diagnosed by gram staining. What is the organism which is involved in the chancroid formation? Leishmania rubrumani, right? Contact dermatitis. You do it with a patch test. Then dermatophytes. This is with the KOH mode. Then Hansen's disease. What is a Hansen's disease? What is Hansen's disease? Leprosy. Leprosy is otherwise called as the Hansen's disease. Is leprosy skin sensation testing is the diagnosis of Hansen's disease. Then herpes, herpetic lesions. Herpetic lesions, you diagnose it with a hand smear. Lupus vulgaris, you diagnose it with a biopsy. Lymphogranuloma venerum, you diagnose it with a GMSA stained a scraping and microscopic examination. Then vitreous versicula, of course, you do it with a Fayot's mold. Psoriasis, how will you diagnose? Diagnose psoriasis with retage test. Syphilis, of course, screening tests, many screening tests are there. The diagnostic would be the dark field microscopy of the spirochetes. Dark field microscopy of the spirochetes. Okay, this is what is regarding the lesions and how you diagnose. Then coming to some lesion and their disease, possible disease, and how you diagnose. A lesion which is with the central clearing tendency. This clear corpus. That was a little Fayot's mold. Right? The lesion with the central scarring. The disease associated with is lupus vulgaris. And the diagnosis is via biopsy. And the disease or the lesion with the central cresting would be leishmaniasis. And the way of diagnosis is the leishmania donovani body demonstration. Right? This is what is regarding the hints regarding the lesions that you have. Then coming to a few types of erythemas. Erythema annulare centrifugal. This is most commonly caused by drugs, infections, and diabetes mellitus. Then, erythema chronica migrans. It will be caused by the Lyme's disease. Lyme's disease is caused by which organism? Lyme's disease is caused by Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
But it's caused by Borrelia burgdorferi, right? It is caused by Borrelia burgdorferi. This Lyme's disease, it can have an erythema chronicum migrans, then erythema gyratum referens. It is caused by malignancy. Erythema induratum. It is caused by Basil's disease. then erythema marginatum, you know this answer. Erythema marginatum, where do you see?
Rheumatic fever.
You see it in rheumatoid, rheumatic fever. Then erythema toxicum. Erythema toxicum is usually seen even in a normal urinator. Right? Then erythema nodosum is usually seen in streptococcal infections, then TB, then leprosy, and sarcoidosis. Then erythema perineum. You see it in chilblains. Then ecthema gangrenosum. Ecthema, not erythema, ecthema. Ecthema gangrenosum. You see this with Pseudomonas aeruginosa infection. Right? Then erythrasma. Erythrasma is caused by? Erythrasma is caused by what?
Carnibacterium.
Yes, carnibacterium. Carnibacterium what? After finishing it.
Minus it is now.
Carnibacterium. Minuticum. Right? Carnibacterium minuticum will be the organism which causes erythrasma. Then coming to a few lesions and their common locations. Where will you see this atopic dermatitis? What is the most common place of location of atopic dermatitis? Be most commonly seen in the antecubital and the popliteal fossa. Antecubital and popliteal fossa. Acne and impetigo can be seen in the face. For day spots, to be seen in the lips. Then herpes genitalis, it will be most commonly seen in the periumbilical region. Right, it will be most commonly seen in the periumbilical region. Herpes simplex, it will be mostly seen in the face. Herpes zoster will be seen in the thorax. Mongolian spots will be most commonly seen in the sacral region, more than the gluteal region, more than the lumbar region. Then morphia, it will be seen in the forehead. Then necrobiosis, diabetic orum. So-called diabetic dermatopathy, dermatonecrobiosis, diabetic orum. It will be seen in the front of legs. Peach-Juba syndrome, you have the lesion in the lips and oral mucosa. Then Mitchell's melanosis. We see in the face and the neck. Then Sjögren's patch. Where do you see Sjögren's patch? Lumbosacral region is the most common thing. Sjögren's patch is mainly seen in tuberous sclerosis. Right? This is what is regarding the disease and their most common location of their spots. Then coming to the getting back to the pictures which we saw. Now try to guess the pictures. This is porphyria cutanea tarda. Okay, this is porphyria cutanea tarda. You guys already told me this one is erythrasma, very good. What is this for? Dilated blood vessels. Now you guess.
Telangiectasia.
Exactly. Telangiectasia. This is telangiectasia. Then this one is milia. The sweat glands are involved. So it's milia. Now what is this one? So these are the yes. What is this one? These are the tunneling inside the epidermis. These are the burrows. Right? We discussed the small burrows means it could be scabies. If it's a long burrows, it could be the hookworm infection. Right? These are the acne, so-called acne. It's called the comedion. These are the six piece. Where did we see six piece? It is lichen planus. Okay, this will be the presentation of lichen planus. Then, these are all looks like a tens bulla, right? Where will you see tens bulla?
Bullous pemphigoid.
Bullous pemphigoid. It's bullous pemphigoid. What is this one? You have an increased turnover of hair here. It's seborrheic dermatitis. This seborrheic dermatitis. This is dermatomyositis. It is dermatomyositis. Then what is this one? This is a mycosis fungoides. This is the fungoides. This will be the presentation. This is after treatment with the Dapsone. Right? Then what is this one? This is pitriasis rubra. You have an erythema of the entire body region. So, this is what is regarding the dermatological parts that you